Hi, I'm Menno Marks. I'm a developer advocate on the Google Maps API team. I'm happy to announce the latest version of the Google Maps SDK for iOS, version 1.7. In 1.7, we introduced two new features, gradient polylines and structured reverse geocoding. Let's start with gradient polylines. Gradient polylines allow you to fill different segments of a polyline with different colors. This is a useful feature for data visualization. You can use different colors to show different variables like, say, elevation. It's also useful for things like routing, for instance, to indicate different speed limits along a route. What you see here is the gradient polylines demo from the SDK demos project that comes with the SDK. This example uses gradient polylines to show the elevation of a walking track on the coast of Italy. The green part of the line represents the highest altitude and then graduates towards orange to red, representing the lowest altitude in the center. The code is pretty simple. Take a look at the documentation and the demos that come with the SDK download. Now let's look at structured reverse geocoding. Since we released the Google Maps SDK in 2012, we've had reverse geocoding, which takes a latitude-longitude pair and returns an address. This is useful for getting an address of someone's current location or the place that they tap on a map. In the past, our reverse geocoder, GMS geocoder, has responded to a latitude-longitude request with the address as a formatted string. With structured reverse geocoding, we return an address object with properties that allow you to easily access its component parts. In this demo, which also comes with the SDK demos, you can see if I do a long press, I get detailed information about the locality, in this case Sydney, the administrative area, New South Wales, and the country, Australia. In addition to these two features, 1.7 includes some bug fixes. So to see a complete list of what's included in 1.7, check out the release notes. And as always, we're really excited to hear your experience using the SDK. Please leave comments here or on our Google Plus page. And as always, if you need any help, go over to Stack Overflow. Our support page has all the tags that you need.